The view looked different depending on where you were in the United States. But one thing most of us had in common was turning our eyes towards the sky this afternoon.
A stunning sight as people cheered as the moon completely covered the sun. For some of us here in Central Florida, we only saw a partial eclipse. But it's an event bringing many people together. And that's why we have team coverage this afternoon.
West 2's Michelle Meredith took in the sight alongside hundreds of high school students at Lake Mary High School. We're going to start things off with First 20 meteorologist Eric Burris, who is live for us at the Orlando Science Center, where they held a big celebration, Eric.
It was quite the party, and from strollers to seniors, there were so many out here with their special fancy glasses on, looking up to the sky. And while it may not have been totality here in Central Florida, 60% was still quite a sight to see.
If you didn't know better, you'd wonder why so many people gathered, all looking up. But the Orlando Science Center took today's eclipse as an opportunity to not only offer viewing, but to teach what is happening and why.
The moon is constantly going around the Earth, and there is eclipses happening all the time, but it's rare where the path of the shadow of it is in an area where people can see it.
And oh, so many of us did see it, using those special glasses or watching the live stream from the Orlando Science Center Observatory. But for Chris Cantrell, today was special for more than just teaching his daughter Kendall about the eclipse. It was about helping the spark in his daughter.
Kendall wants to be an astronaut when she grows up, so every astrological event that comes our way, we try to make sure we can see it.
And through those glasses with her own eyes, you better believe she saw it. You see, she told me she wanted to be the first person to go to Mars. So she has a real interest in learning. And what better place than the Science Center to see and ask questions? Because Kendall may be little now, but she sure has big aspirations in the future.
I'm gonna discover things like water and stuff that on Mars that the rovers can't find on Mars.
So she's soaking up all that she can today. Her dad smiling brighter than the sun, knowing his daughter is making a core memory, one that may just help to drive her in the future.
Just to see them, have this experience as a father means everything.
And as a father, I was completely breathtaking when he was talking to me and when I was talking to her. Now, getting into the science of it, this is where my mind is blown, okay? The sun, 400 times larger than the moon, but the moon, 400 times closer to us than the sun. So from our vantage point, they are the same size. Now, we didn't have totality here, but the next eclipse that comes will be a partial. That'll be in 2044. Then we have totality in Central Florida in 2045. Just to say I'm going to hold my glasses, it may be a thing. The only problem, though, that 2045 eclipse, totality, will be an August afternoon. So we may have to deal with thunderstorms. But, you know, that's 20-something years in the future. We'll just hold our horses until then. That's the very latest from the Orlando Science Center. I'm meteorologist Eric Burris, West 2 News.
We are really expanding the 7-day forecast.
We are, yeah. That's epic.
20 years.
And hopefully we'll all be here to cover it.
Yes, ma'am.
Together.